Good morning. I'm Dr. Atmaram Pawar. I'm presenting here the concepts of the practicals in the pharmaceutics, mainly for first year B-Pharm and Pharm-D. So due to this pandemic situation, now the way of teaching learning is changed, but we have to go ahead. In this case, we are not doing the practical work, but at least we should understand the concepts properly. So my aim is to guide you regarding the concepts of different the formulations in the practicals of the first year B-Pharm and first year Pharm-D. So I will have one typical formula or formulation with the 10 different questions. My aim is not to give answer to these questions, but my aim is make you to find the answer for these questions. My aim is not to make you to recite and mug the things, but understand the concept. What happens if anything is used or not used, likewise. So I have the different books that I'm writing from 2004. So majority of this information is given in that books also. So you can have the reading of the reference books, textbooks, but I think these my questions will help you to understand the practical concepts. So what is the objective of a practical? It is understanding of prescription, understanding of compounding and dispensing, introduction to different dosage forms, selection of container, selection of different storage conditions, understanding of dose, how to administer that dose, the patient instruction at least. So it is not a detailed patient counseling, but patient instructions, how to take, how many to take, before food, after food, likewise. So this is expected in the first year B-Pharm or the Pharm-D. And it is expected from any regulation, and mainly Pharmacy Practice Regulation 2015, where it explains the first component in the pharmacy practice is interpretation and evaluation of the prescription. Knowing the things of drug administration, drug regime review, the patient counseling, and keeping a record of all this. So this regulation came in 2015, but on this basis only, I wrote my first book, that is Modern Dispensing Pharmacy, in 2004, and then I started writing in local languages also. So pharmacy practice regulation also explained the concept of dispensing pharmacy, community pharmacy, compounding likewise. So when I wrote a book, Modern Dispensing Pharmacy, in 2004, many the experts and even our senior faculty members said that now dispensing is over. At that time also, I told, sir, compounding is over and dispensing is started. Now we have to think on the dispensing, where it is the interpretation, evaluation, and supply of a drug, which is rational, which is essential, and which is safety and effective for that patient. It's the dispensing. And a compounding is extemporaneous manufacturing of some product as per the direction of a doctor. That is outdating, but dispensing is upcoming. And due to this Pharm-D and due to the enhancement in the knowledge, socio-economic status, the society also expecting dispensing, rational dispensing from a pharmacist. And therefore, this community pharmacy, this field will emerge in India like all the developed countries. And my motive from day one when I joined is to strengthen the community pharmacy and doing this in different ways. So what is the need of 21st century pharmacist? It is not supply of medicament. No, the supply means supply of grocery items, supply of sand, supply of cement. So we are not supplying, we are dispensing. We are dispensing means the appropriate medicament, rational medicament. We are dispensing with the patient counseling. We are dispensing with making a dialogue with the patient. This is the more important, and this is expected in a doctor of pharmacy, or expected in the pharmacy practice regulation. So therefore, first we'll see what is the prescription. It is might have covered in your theory. The prescription have a different parts. The prescription is an order. Is it order? No. See, the modern dispensing pharmacy is the first book which mentions the prescription is a never order. The prescription is a requisite. The prescription is a request made by a registered medical practitioner. Therefore, we have full capacity and right to reject that prescription if it is wrong. Therefore, we should understand for the prescription. The prescription never be order, but is a written or electronic. A requisite or a request or directives given by registered medical pharmacist, the registered medical practitioner to the registered the pharmacist to dispense the medicament. And therefore, we should understand the parts of prescription. The first prescription, the doctor's detailed information, including his registration number, qualification, and contact. Contact is more important. If anything goes wrong, we have to search that doctor. Therefore, secondly, details of a patient, including age, is important. Address, contact number, body weight, whether if it is a female, then is a lactating or the pregnant. Likewise, all the information regarding the patient is must. Then it comes to the main part, as you know, that is Rx, YD, the written, and all this. So more important is the prescription should be in a capital letters. It should be with the generic name. In the corona, now you see the all the prescriptions, all these prescriptions are with the generic name, because that branded product may or may not available. And second important point is the prescription should contain small note on the diagnosis. This is the first I written in the 2004 book, which I started drafting from 1994, where I included. It is important to write the diagnosis. Now it is accepted in the pharmacy practice regulation also. Third important point is the refill instructions. Again, the modern dispensing pharmacy, the first book to include this refill instructions. The prescription otherwise dispensed many times and it may be misused. Therefore, doctor has to write repeat 1, 2, 3, or don't repeat, or chance may be given to the pharmacist by writing PRN to redispense the medicament. And finally, the signature of a doctor. So this is the component we have to understand. And if this prescription is correct, then start dispensing. Otherwise, you have to contact your doctor and get correct prescription. This is more important. Otherwise, in a society, we have such a prescriptions and our pharmacists are dispensing it. It is very wrong. It is against the law. It is against the ethics, and it is against the responsibility given to you as a pharmacist. This also we have to study and understand in the first year B-Pharm or Pharm-D. Another major part is we have to keep a record. It is called the patient medication record. I included it in 2004 in MDP, and now it is appeared in the pharmacy practice regulation also. And that record have a importance, because this is the record which helps the patient if anything goes wrong, effective or toxic effect, ineffective, costly, what it may be. Sometimes drugs which are of poor quality may be dispensed, or sometimes there may be some drug interaction. So all these issues can be solved if we have the prescription and if we have the patient medication record. It also avoids double dispensing. double dispensing. Sometimes some patient take medicament as OTC and same it is written in the prescription. But if the record is there, definitely it will minimize that error. So record of patient or the prescription record and the prescription are most important for minimizing medication errors. And nowadays, as per the regulation, H1 drugs means antibiotics are properly recorded, all the dispensing is recorded. And last point is, we have to understand the what is the dosage form, why drug is converted into a dosage form. So what are the dosage form? Tablet, capsule, liquid, syrup, elixir, ointment, these are the dosage form. What is the drug? Drug is paracetamol, azithromycin, CPM, cetirizine, all these are the drugs. So why that drug is converted into dosage form? Means why paracetamol is formulated as syrup, as the elixir, as the tablet, as the injection. What are the different reasons? Whether to improve viability, whether to improve storage stability, whether to ease the administration by a particular route, ease of manufacturing, improve acceptability by patient, for its safety or easy to handle. And what are the different ingredients are added in that? How a container is selected? All these parameters we have to understand primarily at this level. Again, in the third year B-Pharm or third year Pharm-D, we have to study this on the large scale. But at least we have to understand why particular drug is formulated in particular dosage form. What are the roles of different ingredients used? So this is the more important in the practical purpose. So therefore, this is the case I am giving. That is the paracetamol syrup. So different ingredients are there. Paracetamol, invert syrup, alcohol, propylene glycol, raspberry juice, methylparaben, glycerin. Likewise, correct. So we have to understand. So what is the, create a case. Create a case, don't read the definition, don't read the prescriptions, but understand the prescriptions. I seen in many universities, teachers are asking the student to recite the complete formula. No, it is not expected at all. What is expected is that why invert syrup is used. What is the difference between syrup and invert syrup? Why alcohol is used? Why 25 gram paracetamol is used in the 100 ml of the preparation? Means what is the dose? What is the strength of that preparation? Likewise, so all these things pharmacists should know. Regarding the stability, regarding the indication, contraindication. So this is expected. So my appeal is always, I have number of videos on my channel, SIM Pharmacist, where I mentioned the interactive teaching for better and effective knowledge delivery. I want knowledge. I expect knowledge. Mars will be there, but Mars will not be along with you. Only knowledge will be remain with you. Therefore, understand the formulation, understand the principle, do not reset the formula. This is my request. And in the examination also, no any examiner should ask to write the formulas along with the quantities. Okay, if you want to ask them to write the different ingredients and what is the role of that, but there is no need to reset the quantities. This is more important. Another confusion in the label. In the label, so at the first year B-Pharm, we are having the dispensing concept. And in the third year Pharm-D or a B-Pharm, we have the manufacturing concept. Manufacturing label is different, what we are observing on the marketed product. So dispensing label should have a name of doctor, that is prescriber, prescribed for name of patient, then the repacked by or compounded by, then the date of compounding or date of repacking, used before, or one can write used within 1 month likewise, and dose and storage condition. So this is the dispensing pack. In the first year, we have to make such a labels. Direction for external use, sequel before use. Okay, you write it and label should be like this. Manufacturing date, expiry date, batch number, manufacturing license number. These are for a third year B-Pharm or third year Pharm-D. So with this, I cover this first introductory part, what to study in our the practicals. and definitely one by one we'll take a one formulation, and I will try to explain how to understand that dosage form. I'm not here to give you answers, but I will make you to find the answers. I'll make you to study more, think it, how it is happening. This is more important as a knowledge. So thank you. So have the next all videos for you only, for your benefit. Thank you. Thank you once again.